In this video, I'm going to be talking about loops in Python, and we'll be seeing that why loops are important in Python and what makes loop an important Python concept. So let me start by making a new file called tutorial14.py, and we'll explore what loops in Python or loops in programming in general are. So there are two types of loop commands in Python. They are while loop and for loops. So let me say, primarily there are two types of loops in Python. Number one, while loops, and number two, for loops. So I want to comment these out, and I'll be starting with for loops. So let me say for loops and while loops, and we'll see what the syntax of for loops is and what the syntax of while loop is. So what is a loop? So the loop is an instruction that keeps on executing as long as a given condition is true. So I'll define it by saying a loop is used to execute a set of statements as long as a given condition is true. So let's see how this works in action. So we'll be starting by writing for loop in Python. So if I say something like for I in range, and let me say 10. So range is a function over which you can use for loops to iterate. So if I say for I in range 10, and if I say something called print I, and if I run this program, you'll see that 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 has been printed on my output window. Now you might be thinking that why to use loops when we can use print statements? The answer is that if I ask you to print 0 to 5, you can easily use print statements and print 0 to 5. If I ask you to print 0 to 9, you can easily do that by using print statement. But if I ask you to print 0 to 10,000 or 0 to 1 million for that matter, it'll be very difficult for you. So if I do something like this, I'll see 0 to 999 printing on the screen. And you can see that Python is doing this real fast. So you need not worry about typing and writing multiple print statements and then managing enormous amount of code. You don't want to manage a code which is 1,000 or 1,100 lines long. So I hope you understood why loops are important. So now that we saw this loop, I will show you how to iterate through list using a for loop. Using for loop. So let me save it, and then I'll do something like this. I'll say my list is equal to, I'll say this, and then I'll say that, and then I'll say Harry, and then I'll say perfect. And let me add a number as well. I'll say 45. Now if I say something like for item in my list, and if I do something like this, print item. So what this will do is it will assume item as the item inside this list. What this means is that it will keep on picking one item after the other from my list. One by one, you will see this, that, Harry, perfect, and 45 being stored into item variable. So when first iteration of this loop occurs, you will see this, then that, then Harry, then perfect, then 45. And now since 45 is the last element of this list, you will see nothing after that, and for loop will terminate. So if I run this program, let me get rid of this 0 to 1000. But again, let it print. It has been completed till 400, 500, 600. Let me terminate this program and run it again, because it is annoying for you guys to see 0 to 1000 to be printed on the screen. So as you can see that we have this, that, Harry perfect in 45 printed on our output window. Why this happened? This happened because when we say for item in my list, the items from my list will keep on getting assigned to item, and we'll see item as this, that, Harry perfect and 45 one by one. Now item is nothing special. You can say something else like I, but you'll have to say I here as well. And if I run this program, you will see the same output. If I say J, then I'll have to say J here as well, and I'll see exactly the same output. So item is not a Python keyword or something. Item is something that we are writing for a convenience so that we can understand that why we are using this temporary variable. So I hope you understood how we use for loops to iterate over a list. Similarly, you can iterate over a tuple as well as a set as well as a dictionary. So we'll see the examples of that as well. So let us say I have a tuple. So if I say iterating a tuple, and if I say my tuple is equal to, and I'll say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and Harry, and I can do exactly the same thing, nothing new. All you have to do is you have to replace my list with my tuple, and you will see exactly the same output, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and Harry, nothing new in that. In case of dictionaries, however, so I'll say my dict is equal to, and I'll say name, and I'll say Harry, and I'll say, let me write it like this. Now you can give as many spaces as you want, and you can beautify this as per your needs. I'll say color, and then I'll say green, and then let me also say marks, and let me give myself 100 out of 100 marks. And after this, let me remove all the redundant spaces, and after this I'll say for item in my dict. If I do something like this, and if I print item, and if I run this program, you can see that it is printing name, color and marks. So by default, it will print only the keys. So let me comment this one, iterating a tuple, as well as let me comment this one because it is making this confusing. And if I run this program once again, you'll see name, color and marks being printed on the screen. So in order to print both keys and values, you'll have to do something like my dict.items. And if you do something like this, you'll see, so I'll have to write items and not item. Let me run this program, and you'll see that I have tuples which contains nothing but key values, key and corresponding value, key and corresponding value, key and corresponding value. So I can do something like for key comma value in my dict.items, and you can say I can write an f string here. I can say the key is, and I'll say key, and I'll say, and the value is, I'll say value. Now you can write K and V, you can write some other name. I am writing key value because it suits the occasion and it makes it more readable. Let me run this program, and you'll see the key is name and the value is Harry, key is color and the value is green, key is marks and the value is 100. So this is how you iterate a dictionary. And if you write only my dict, let me write it here, iterating to get keys as well as the corresponding values. And also I'll say that if you try to iterate through the dictionary, you will get keys by default. So this means that if you do not write this dot items, and if you try to iterate this dictionary, you will get only keys. But if you want both keys and values, you can use something called mydict.items. This will give you keys as well as the values. So I hope this is clear now. Now I want to give you a quick quiz, and the quiz is, so let me write it down here, and you have to comment down the answer. You have a dictionary of dictionary with keys as names of the students of a class and values as their marks. You have to print the student name as well as his marks. So all you have to do is you have to print the name of the student and you have to print his marks. So all you have to do is pretty print this data which is contained in the dictionary. So I hope you'll do it easily. You can use dot items, whatever you want to use. You just have to use that dictionary and you have to give me pretty printed student names and their corresponding marks. So I hope you like this video. If you like this video, give this video a thumbs up. Please do not forget to give me a thumbs up, as well as make sure to access this course playlist. That way you will get all the videos as and when they are uploaded to this playlist. Also subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And if you have any doubt, make sure to post it down in the comment sections below. Thank you so much guys for watching this video, and I will see you next time.